Hello guys, this is Asharam, and in this video I'll discuss the solution of perfect power divisor problem of CodeChef April Long Challenge 2020. So let's read the problem statement. So there is some function f of m, which is sum of all the perfect powers which divides m. So positive integer k is a perfect power. It can be represented as x to the power y, whereas y is greater than 1. So you have to find f of 1 plus f of 2 plus f of n and modulo this number. And constraints are till n is till 10 to the power 18. So let's see some examples first. So suppose let's say n is 4. Now f of 1 is, so 1 is divisible by only 1 square. So f of 1 is 1, and then f of 2, so even 2 is divisible by only power of 1, so f of 2 is 1. Then f of 3 is also 1 similarly. And now f of 4 is divisible by 1 and 2 square. So f of 4 is 1 plus 4, 5. So its whole summation is 8. So our algorithm should return 8. And for n is equals to 14. So f of 5 equal to f of 6 equal to f of 7 is 1. And now f of 8 is, because 1 comma 2 square comma 2 cube divides f of 8, so f of 8 will be, so it will be 13. And then f of 9 is 10, because it is divisible by 1 and 3 square. And then f of 10 equal to f of 11 equal to 1. And now f of 12 is 5, because it is divisible by 1 and 2 square. And f of 13 equal to f of 14 equal to 1. So if you sum all of them, you will get 43. So for n equal to 14, the algorithm should return 43. So let's see how we can solve this problem. So first of all, let's add a page. So now suppose that you are trying to find f of m. So now what we'll do is, we'll check which perfect power. So we have, suppose we are trying to calculate this till f of 1. So now we'll see, for let's first perfect power is obviously 1. So we'll see in which of these expressions 1 will come. So we'll check whether 1 divides m, or 1 divides m minus 1, or 1 divides 1 or not. So since you know that 1 divides m, 1 divides m minus 1, and 1 divides 1, so 1 will contribute to n, because f of m, there will be some 1 plus something, f of m minus 1 will be 1 plus some other perfect powers, and f of 1 is 1. So 1 will contribute to n. Now we'll move to 2 square. So next power is 2 square, as you know. So next powers are 2 square, 2 to the power cube, and till 2 to the power 64, because this is the maximum number of 2 to the power 16 is approximately 2 to the power 18. So now suppose, so 2 to the power square will divide 4, then it will divide, so it will divide 1 into 1, then it will divide 2 into 4, and then it will divide 3 into 4, and then it will divide 4 into 4, and then it will divide n into 4. So so 2 to the power square will divide these only terms which are multiples of 4, so it will divide only those m's which are multiples of 4. So how many m's are multiples of 4? So you can easily see that this is m divided by 4, greatest integer. So suppose m is 6, then m by 4 is 1, because only 4 is divisible. So 6 is not divisible, 5 is not divisible, only f of 4. So only 4 is divisible by 2 square. So So 2 square will contribute to m by 2 square. Similarly, 2 cube will contribute to m upon 2 to the power cube. And similarly, you can find for 2 to the power 64. Now we'll do the same thing for 3 square, 3 cube, and till 3 to the power x less than, such that it is just less than 10 to the power 18. So is it just less than m actually? Okay, so m is less than or equal to 10 to the power 18. So yeah, so similarly 3 square will contribute to m upon 3 square, and m 3 4 it will contribute to m upon 3 to the power 4. So yeah, so this is the general idea. So you check for all the perfect powers and then you sum all of them. So I can say that it will be m by 1 plus m by 2 square plus all the perfect powers of 2 plus then m by 3 square and all the perfect power 3. Now you can see that we don't need to include 4 perfect powers of 4 because 4 square is equivalent to 2 to the power 4. So there is no point in doing that, okay, because we have already calculated here. Then again, yeah, similar 5 square, sorry, and then similarly. So this will go on till root m, okay, root m square. So yeah, so it should take you O of root m time, because O of root m time. So you might argue that here this we are calculating it 64 times instead of 1. So here it is 64 and here I don't know exactly, so it will be around something 30-40 and then it will reduce drastically. There will drastic changes. So till when you get till 10, then you have to just calculate for 10, sorry, for till only 18 times, okay. So it will change at a drastic, in very large speed. So your time complexity will approximately O of root of m. And also you have to check whether, like these, m of 4, so 4 is a perfect power, so 4 is square of some number or it is a cube of some number, not, okay. So you have to check that also. So instead of checking that, you can create initially an array and find all the numbers less than 10 to the power 9 which are power of some another number, okay. And yeah, you will be able to do it easily, okay. And it will hardly take, yeah, it will take root of 10 to the power 9 time, okay. So you can create a boolean array for that to check whether some number n is power of some another number or not, okay. So we are not including those numbers, okay. So we are not including 4, we are not including 8, we are not including 9, not including 16, like this. And you can see that if this is greater than 1, so if we say that this is greater than root m, so for if we try to include this m upon root m plus 1 whole square, so this will get us, this will evaluate to 0, so there is no point in doing that. So yeah, so this is root m algorithm for this problem. So yeah, so root m will work for first 3 subtasks, that is till m is 10 to the power 12, because then our algorithm will take 10 to the power 6 iterations and which will easily pass 2 seconds time constraints. So now, so we have to do something different for 10 to the power 18 cases, okay, when m is 10 to the power 18. So now let's see what we can do. So now instead of checking for a perfect power, means we are dividing how many times a perfect power is appearing, okay. So first of all, you know that only 10 to the power 6 till, so only cubes of number till 10 to the power 6 will divide m equal to 10 to the power 18. So you know that, okay. So you can do, so what you can do is you can find all the perfect numbers which are cube of some other numbers, so which are cube or which are 4th power of some number x, or which are 5 or so. So you can do it in 10 to the power 6 iterations. Okay, so you can do this for cube 4 and then this biquadratic and then x to the power 5 and so on. So you can do this for these types of perfect numbers, but for x square we have to take, our algorithm is taking 10 to the power 9 iterations. So you can see that we have to do something different for x square only. So for these numbers we'll follow our initial algorithm and we'll do something different for x squared numbers. Those are perfect squares. Okay, so instead of finding how many times a number, and okay, before that there is one more thing that you can do. You can do this for numbers till 10 to the power 6. Okay, so you can find contributions of all the perfect square numbers till 10 to the power 6. So 10 to the power 12. So this, okay. Yeah. Okay. So you can do this thing for till 10 to the power 6 numbers only. So now we have to do something different for numbers between 10 to the power 6 and 10 to the power 9. Because their square will also divide m and will give some definite integer 1 or 2, 3. Okay, so let's see what different we can do for this range. So now instead of finding how many times a perfect square is appearing, so we were finding how many times a perfect square were appearing, we'll check how many perfect square will appear k times. So our initial question was how many times a perfect number is appearing. Okay, and yeah, there has been one big mistake, that is we have to multiply them by 2 square, 3 square and then 5 square and so on. Okay, don't forget to do that. I just summed it directly. I think I forgot to mention that. Okay, so you have to, so for adding the contribution you have to multiply them. Okay, so now our initial question was how many times a perfect number is appearing, and now our question is changed. Our question is how many perfect square numbers, because we are done with cube numbers and we are done with perfect square numbers which are square of number till 10 to the power 6, because we can do that in 10 to the power 6 iterations only and which will pass the time constraints, and we have to do something different for this. So how many perfect square are appearing k times? So yeah, so let's add a page first. Okay, so let's say m of x square is k. So initially let's start with 1 only. Okay, so let's say k is 1. Let's try to understand for k equal to 1. So then x square equal to m upon 1. So x is under root of m. Okay, now for let's say k equal to 2, let's make this x1. So x1 square equal to m by root 2. It will be 2 and x1 equal to root m by 2. Now if x1 is greater than, so this is greatest integer. Okay, so this is integer division, you can understand it. Okay, so now if x1 is greater than under root m by 2, so let's say x1 is something m by 2.5. So not 2.5, something 1.9, let's say. Okay, because x1 is greater than m by 2 and root m upon 1.9 is greater than root m by 2. So in that case it will appear x1 square times, so x1 will appear this many times, so it will be m square upon m square 1.9. So since we are taking greatest integer, so it will be evaluated to 1. So it will evaluate 1 equal to 1. So you can see that all the integers between x and x1 are coming one time. Okay, so in similar fashion you can say that, so between root m and root m by 2, we are saying that it is coming one time, and between root m and root m by 3, it will come two time. Okay, and then between root m by 4, it will appear three times, and similarly for other number also. So as you know, so these are our x values of x. So we have to repeat this same thing till our value of x become 10 to the power 6. So till k such that root m by k is less than or equal to 10 to the power 6. Okay, so we have to repeat it till then. So for that, if in worst case, so before that there should be one more page. So in worst case, m is 10 to the power 18. So and upon k equal to 10 to the power 12. I would square it, so k equal to 10 to the power 6. So to get till 10 to the power 6, it will take only 10 to the power 6 iterations. Okay. So in this way, we are able to find how many perfect squares are appearing one time. So and two times, three times, and so on till k times. And we are able to do in 10 to the power 6 iterations. And now you can use sum of squares formula, okay, to calculate. So now, so their contribution will be, so there will be some squares here, perfect squares, okay, x1 square, x2 square, something like these, okay. So you can sum them using sum of square formula, that is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 for first n squares. So since there we have a difference here, so what we'll do is we'll find the difference of squares between root m and root m by 2, first root m and first root m by 2 integers. So let's call it x1, let's call it x2. So then it will be simply x1 into x1 plus 1 into 2x1 plus 6 minus x2 into x2 plus 1 and so on upon 6 till, okay. So yeah, so you can find the sum, and then contribution will be multiplied by 1 because it is appearing only, they are appearing only one time, then they are appearing here two times, so you will multiply it by 2 and you will add this result to the final answer. Okay, so you might claim that why we are not using this method for whole k, all of them. Okay, so you can see that, so m by k is, let's say till we are going till x equal to 1, so then k equal to m, that is 10 to the power 18 iterations. So this is not feasible, therefore we are doing it till only k into 10 to the power 6, and for other part we are using our normal brute force method. Okay, so this is the reason. And now one thing at which you have to be careful is you should not compute. So I told you to compute perfect square till 10 to the power 6, okay. So now, and these powers x to the power 4, x to the power 5. So now you have to be careful to be not, so you have to be careful that you should not compute any perfect square which is coming between 10 to the power 6 and 10 to the power 9. So you should not compute the result for any square of number between 10 to the power 6 and 10 to the power 9 here. Okay, so this is the only thing you have to be careful, and also be careful at these square roots. Okay, so in C++, so in use square root L. If you use square root, you'll get inaccurate results, and one of your final test cases will get failed. Okay, so use square root L. Okay, so now let's see the code for it. Okay, so this is my code. So yeah, so now initially I created a boolean array to store all the perfect power, to check whether a number is till 10 to the power 9, whether a number is perfect power or not. And I also created initial array of squares of numbers. Okay, and now initially I'll do for all the cubes, all the power 4, all the power 5s. So I'll add my contribution. Okay, so this is the code for that. So now you can do it easily. This is pretty straight. I'm not explaining it right now. Okay, and now this is my 10 to the power 6 till 10 to the power 19 part of squares. Sorry, 10 to the power 6 till 10 to the power 9 part of square. And this is my 1 to the part 1 to 10 to the power 6 part of square. Okay. And you can see that I have used square root L function. Remember that you have to use only square root L function, or else you'll get inaccurate result and your last test case will get failed for sure. Okay. And also you can note that I have created a boolean array of 10 to the power 9 size. So note that I have created a boolean array of 10 to the power 9. Don't try to create an integer array or long int array of 10 to the power 9 size, or else you'll get runtime errors or compile time errors. Okay, I think you'll get compile time errors. So yeah, that's it guys for now. I hope you like this tutorial, and also check out other problem solutions of CodeChef April Long Challenge 2020. So yeah, thank you guys.